look at RPA, robotic process automation, what we are doing here is this technology is just simulating human behavior on a computer. So anything a person, you know, it can read a computer screen, it can type on a computer screen, it can operate any application. It doesn't matter which application, SAP, PeopleSoft, Workday, it's fine. It can operate any of these applications just like you and I can. So that's the technology that we are talking about today. A software bot can come and do the work exactly the same as what we do. This is like a total change that's happening in the industry right now. It's impossible to tell whether the work is being done by a robot or a human being. If you combine this with the artificial intelligence, then everything that we are doing, like the doing part, analyzing, improving, everything is going to be done by these software parts. So if you look at it, again, this is written software parts. This is nothing but code that we are already used to writing, except we don't have to write a lot of code. There are tools that are out there that are generating the code behind the scenes. As long as it's a rule-based and there is a certain process that you can configure on a program saying that, hey, if this happens, you do this. If this happens, you do this. The bots will understand that and do exactly what you ask them. They are not intelligently able to do. If it doesn't match, the bot will just fail and say, hey, I failed. Here's the notification, send out an email. Then you have to go back and reprogram that for that particular exception. So they are pretty good at handling exceptions. There are a number of ways that we can actually code exceptions. This is actually where the coding part and companies like us come in, because there are a lot of exceptions that you can write into these bots where the bots don't fail. Right? So that's where anybody can create a bot, but when it comes to writing these exceptions and how we handle what happens when these exceptions come, who needs to be notified, how are we going to manage this exception, that's where there's a lot of coding. So where are we heading? Right now it's at $60 million, the RPA market. In the next 8 years, it's projected to go to $60 billion. It's a 1,000% increase. So, which is what I was mentioning earlier, that Fortune 50 has implemented. Now Fortune 500 don't have a choice. When Fortune 500 don't have a choice, all the mid-market companies won't have a choice but to implement and start working on this kind of technology. So it kind of you know, goes through one after another. As you can see, this is going to affect every sector of the industry. It is not going to be limited to the HR part or this part or that part of the industry. It's across the board, every company. Evolution of RPA. We all know about trigger-based automation. I also worked in IT for many years, so I know the automation the way we did it a long time ago. We wrote batch scripts left and right, self scripting and units. So 40 million human jobs will be automated in the next 5 years. It's not that people are going to lose their jobs. We always find a way to create more jobs, which is a good thing. What is the loss if they don't? This is very, very, if you're a private enterprise, it's very, very critical, what you're going to lose if you don't implement. So if the Chase is implementing and they're able to savings of 50 people in one division, and if they implement across all the divisions, they might create the savings of 1,000 people. That is a lot of money. And if another competitor, they don't implement a similar technology or something and like that, or something that saves them those 1,000 jobs, now they're behind. Right? So the cost savings part is very important. That's what is going to drive this technology forward, whether it's RPA or whether it's going into the next level of cognitive work. And this by itself, this is a very simple technology to implement. Unfortunately, or fortunately, because it's going to affect a lot of human jobs, the way we know it, jobs. And this technology is very simple to implement. And it can take out jobs in no time. I mean, I can create a bot in like less than 2 days. And I can kill 20% of the job of a human being in that one bot, 2 days. So it is not trying to make it in a negative way, but this technology is here whether we like it or not. We just have to, just like the way we have been absorbing various technologies over the years, we just have to absorb this technology and figure out how to move forward past this technology. Right? So RPA implementation, this is for people that want to implement RPA, the first thing is you need to identify what processes are good candidates for RPA. Then identify the people that are going to be able to help you. Identify technology. There are three technology partners that we put here, but there are other vendors that provide a similar technology. But most times what I hear in the market are these three. You will hear it back to back anywhere you go and you see RPA. So as part of the appendix, context. I'm heading the practice for RPA at Comtech. We have a division called Unlocked Insights.com. It's strictly focused.